Everybody, it's Peter, and yesterday was Season 6, Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Episode 1, Missing Pieces. But again, not feeling up to snuff. I'm also behind on Game of Thrones, in case anybody was looking for that. Well, one, because...
Previously on Game of Thrones, Episode 3.
I think it's just everything's just... I'm not jumping on everything. And speaking of Marvel, Endgame, I've seen Endgame twice, still want to do a review. I wasn't impressed with it as I was with Infinity Wars, but let's get to this episode. Of course, as always, don't forget to hit subscribe, hit the like, hit the notifications, because I am trying to post on a regular basis, and let's just jump into it. So I missed slightly, probably was a previously for 2 minutes of, you know, remember what happened, because it's almost a year since season 5, which wasn't that great. S.H.I.E.L.D. in space. I know a lot of people actually have seen some reviews also too, trying to see who else has been reviewing, if this is a thing or if nobody's really interested in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. in doing reviews other than Marvel pushing their product. I wasn't happy with season 5. This could be the same thing too. We're now in, we're partially in space because again we have to go looking for Fitz, because I do believe we lost Fitz in season 5. That's how much I remember of it. I just remember that they can go back because Fitz shows up in the future from season 5 to save the gang from the Kree with Enoch. And I believe, yeah, the episode does start off after the previously with Enoch looking over Fitz in the cryo tube. So we're now in present day S.H.I.E.L.D. territory. And we've got Davis, Piper, and we find out later Quake are trying to, they've got a tricked out Quinjet that's made for space. I think they took the Kree jump mechanism, because it was shown later on the episode where it's, they can load in a gizmo and a half-fly. But wait a minute, isn't that Star Trek Discovery Spore Drive? They load in a cartridge and go, poof, except they don't go, ping. It's just a regular, you know, hyper jump kind of thing like we see in other sci-fi. But I thought, great, we're in space again. We are still using a lighthouse, which is now a totally tricked out S.H.I.E.L.D. headquarters with Mac in charge. Yo-Yo's an agent still. We still got May and a whole whack of brand new faces. You have no idea who the hell these people are. Sounds like half of them got nicknames. I think Mac likes giving everybody nicknames and not real names. I couldn't tell because there was like so many people in the room. You know, you've got agents with headphones on and this going on, and then you got a strike team. And we also, when we come back to that too, they are trying to zero on something which we don't know what's going on. And what happens? Some anomaly opens up on a wall. Some bearded looking pirate, bald-headed biker hipster kind of guy comes out, I'm assuming from the future, kind of got a Mad Max vibe about him. That's I'm finding this is basically, and now we're doing space, now we're doing Mad Max, because all the guys look like I'm assuming post-apocalyptic. Also there's been two trailers running around too, so you kind of get an idea. Okay, spoilers, you know, we find out that Coulson, it's Clark Gregg, but playing another character in, if you look at IMDb, he is credited as Sarge. And he's the big reveal at the end of it, so I'm getting ahead of myself. But yeah, that's the whole episode is just Daisy Quake running around, trying to find, Gemma is with Daisy as well, they're trying to find Fitz. That's their whole mission. And supposedly, I forget how long it's been going on, it has been a year since the previous season, so a lot's been going on. Everything from Max trying to keep things going, so I guess it's been a whole year to trick out and make a brand new headquarters. Find out later in episode 2 that Yo-Yo and Mac are not a thing, but when she was sparring with May, I guess to get their skills back up, I think she's got her little, some kind of, oh, that's right, she lost her hands, that's why she has the funny hands. I totally forgot everything. That's right. Yo-Yo still has her mechanical hands. They're doing a sparring session and somehow it comes up and says, oh, by the way, I heard you're going out with somebody. No, we're not. Yes, you. Look, if you want to do something, go for it. Like, get over Mac and have a relationship. And then I forget which guy is some chiseled-looking cute guy. Kind of looked like one of the guys out of Captain America, the guy that was the bad guy who's an ex-wrestler turned actor. I forget the actor's name. You can look it up. I don't feel like bothering. And Yo-Yo says to the guy too, oh, they're on to us, you know, we better keep low. And it sounds like they're in a critical situation, so I guess they have time to hook up and stuff like that. And I mean, there's nothing wrong with relationships and stuff like that. But when you're in the middle of something, you're trying to save the day. I guess there is time to, you know, get a bit nooky on the side, that kind of thing. But still, it's not drawing me in. It's like, okay, now we're doing, again, soap, Gilmore Girl kind of stuff. I mean, the writing on S.H.I.E.L.D. is slightly better. It's just the subject matter and just the whole thing is. Not too much arguing in this episode. To me, though, Mac doesn't strike me as a strong leader. He maybe gets the job done. He can fix things. But we'll see how that's going to, you know, pander out through this episode, through this season, sorry. And I don't know if we're going to have a full 20 episodes like a regular TV show. I'm not too sure. Since everything now is running, you know, 10, 15. I have no idea what the plan is for season 6. I really think they should just give it up because it's really been an iffy series for me. Like season 1, I've got, as you can see, there's my copy of season 1. The pilot was beautiful. The show was really good. But then as we moved on, and I wasn't doing reviews back then either. I wasn't happy with that. It was like characters arguing, Hydra, S.H.I.E.L.D., Ghost Rider, the Inhumans, which are not Inhumans. They're basically kind of mutant type because of that Kree stuff that everybody would turn into, you know, supers. And a lot of bouncing around all this time. And then, of course, then S.H.I.E.L.D. in space last year. So I have no idea what's going to go on with this. It's basically we're playing catch up right now and trying to find who this other big bad is. And then the big reveal at the end is they had to blow up a building because supposedly when these bad guys warp in from whatever timeline, they showed one of the guys actually got stuck in a wall. They actually were able to phase from whatever dimension. I'm assuming it's a timey-wimey thing. Again, we're doing timey-wimey and we're doing space. We just did that with Avengers, Infinity War, and Endgame. Okay, we didn't do timey-wimey. We did timey-wimey in Endgame. But still, you know, same thing. We're hitting the sci-fi notes. So it's going to be a bit much, in my opinion, anyway. So, again, I will probably sit it out. I will try and do reviews as best I can. I will try to keep up on Game of Thrones. I think I might just do the last three. I'll do episode 3, 4, and 5. Because, again, last week's episode 2, I thought, oh, it's going to be the big fight. So, nope, they're going to save the big fight for episode 5. And then I guess they're going to clean it all up in episode 6 and so much for Game of Thrones. I have no idea what's going on in the series. And like I said, still got movies to review. See what's going to happen this year. Again, nothing really exciting. I think, again, too, like there's been a lot of postings about fatigue. I am just fatigued with a lot of series in general. It's all been done. It's overdone. Of course, I'm up there. So I've seen tons of movies, tons of shows, tons of concepts, and it does get tiresome after a while. I think I'd love it to see something new. For example, there's one, it's a few years old, but look it up. And actually, it's a good, quirky little independent movie. It's called Safety Not Guaranteed, also about time travel. But you don't find out about the end and you think, oh, some guy's a nut and he's advertising time travel. It has Aubrey Plaza is the only character I know in it. Really quirky characters. But this guy is like, you know, I build a time machine in my backyard and come, you know, go with me. And then the punchline. Okay, I don't want to spoil it, but basically it was like the best ending I ever saw where it's just like, oh, okay, I did not expect, and I love when I watch a movie where I don't expect it, but I'm watching everything now because, again, I've seen too much. Truth be told, I'm going to be 56 this year, and I've seen a ton of movies, everything from, you know, Casablanca, Lawrence of Arabia, 60s movies, things from the 70s. You know, I grew up on Star Trek, Star Wars, Doctor Who. It gets thin after a while. It's like nobody knows what to do anymore, and when they do come up with something wonderful or amazing, something that's like, yeah, it's been done, or hey, like Avatar, it's got all the CGI and everybody loved it and made all this money. But I'm just like, how much CGI can you throw at me in like 2.5 hours? Too much. I find they're putting it too much glitter and things. Luckily, S.H.I.E.L.D. doesn't do that, but that's what I'm finding with a lot of things. Sorry for the rambling and the ranting. I should actually just do a ramble and ranting just on my thoughts on Hollywood processes right now with making movies and TV shows and stuff like that and things on Netflix. It's getting to be too much. It's not pulling me anymore. And I don't think it's an age thing. I think it's just I've seen too much. So it's more of a media burnout. Yes, I've seen that idea. Yes, I've seen that concept. There's only 32 concepts to work with. There's only so many types of stories we can tell. Think of something new, people. Come on. Anyway, enough of that. As you can see, I wasn't impressed with this week's episode. Not impressed what's out there right now either. So, but if you want to hear more of my ranting and babbling, don't forget to hit subscribe, hit notifications. I do post on a randomly weekly basis. And as always, I will see you in the next one.